In this video, we are going to see 3rd Standard Science Term 3 Lesson 1 Our Environment. Our environment consists of everything around us. Yes, what are the things we see around us? Everything is known as our environment. It has living things and non-living things. We are surrounded by living things such as human beings, birds, animals, plants and etc. And non-living things such as cycle, table, car and etc. The living things and non-living things in our environment interact with one another. Our environment is a wonderful gift to us given by the nature. Do you know? World Environment Day is observed on June 5th every year for encouraging worldwide awareness and action to protect our environment. Environmental factors. Our environment has two main factors. They are biotic factors, abiotic factors. Biotic factors. Living organisms in our environment are called biotic factors. For example, lion, plantain, dove, human beings and etc. Biotic factors breathe and grow. They need food to live. They can feel. They give birth to young ones. Abiotic factors. Non-living things in our environment are called abiotic factors. Example, air, soil, water, sunlight, temperature and etc. Abiotic factors cannot breathe and grow. They don't need food to live. They cannot feel. They don't give birth to young ones. Difference between biotic and abiotic factors. Biotic factors, they can breathe and grow. Abiotic factors, they cannot breathe and grow. Biotic factors need food to live. Abiotic factors, they do not need food to live. Biotic factors can feel. Abiotic factors cannot feel. Biotic factors give birth to young ones. Abiotic factors do not give birth to young ones. Do you know? Plants cannot move around like animals, but they grow and their shoots show movements towards the sun. So the plants are also biotic factors. More to know. Amoeba is an unicellular organism. Unicellular means one cell organism. It has the ability to alter its shape. That is, it can able to change its shape. It was discovered in 1755. Interaction between biotic and abiotic factors. All biotic factors depends upon abiotic factors for their living. Biotic and abiotic factors are linked to each other by the flow of energy through food. Plants are the most important among all the living organisms because they only can make food for abiotic factors like air, soil, water, and sunlight. For example, plants. Plants are the biotic factors. They depend upon the abiotic factors such as soil, water, sunlight, air. Yes, plants need soil, water, air, sunlight. Then only they can prepare food. Human beings. Human beings are biotic factors. They depend upon plants, water, air, animals and sunlight. Yes, they depend upon the abiotic factors. Yes, human beings need air to breathe, water to drink, and they need plants and animals to eat, and also they need sunlight. Birds. Birds depend upon abiotic factors such as air, water, sunlight, insects, and trees. Yes, birds need air to breathe, they need insect to eat, they need water to drink and they stay in the trees. And also they need sunlight. Insects. Insects depend upon the abiotic factors such as air, soil, small creatures and plants. They eat small creatures and plants. Some insects, they live in the plants and soil and they need air to breathe. By seeing this picture, we understand that plants need water, soil, air and sunlight to live. Balanced ecosystem. Before getting to this topic, let us see some questions. Just imagine an environment where there are only plants, deer and lions. What will happen to the deer if we remove all the lions? Yes, they will not die. So, as it is, they will be. What will happen to the plants if there are no lions to eat the deer? Yes, the plants are not enough for the deer. If all the plants are eaten, what will happen to the deer? Yes, deer will not survive without plants. A balanced ecosystem supports animals, plants and microorganisms to grow in their environment. Yes, it is important for the food chain to exist in any ecosystem to make sure that the energy flows between the biotic and abiotic factors. An ecosystem is balanced when the biotic and abiotic factors are able to cycle the energy and food as per their need. So, balanced ecosystem is very important for biotic and abiotic factors. The biotic factors in an ecosystem includes producers, consumers, and decomposers. Producers. The living things that can prepare their own food are called producers. Green plants are the producers. They make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Hence, they are called primary producers. Human beings and animals depend on plants for their food. Yes, we are all depend on the plants for our food. So, the plants are the producers. Do you know, few plants do not produce their food and they depend on other plants. They are called parasitic plants. For example, cuscuta. You can see in that picture. Then let us see consumers. The living things that eat food prepared by the producers are called consumers. Most of the living things depend directly or indirectly on the producers for their food. Yes, human beings, animals, birds, all are depending directly or indirectly on the producer, that is plants. Consumers can be divided into three types based on their food, as herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Plant eating animals are called as herbivores. For example, rabbit, deer and etc. Carnivores. Flesh eating animals are called carnivores. For example, tiger, lion and etc. Omnivores. Both plant and flesh eating animals are called omnivores. For example, crow, dog, including human beings. Then let us see decomposers. Organisms that feed on the waste, dead plants and animals are called decomposers. They return the nutrients to the soil. For example, bacteria and fungi. Yes, they only decompose the dead plants, dead animals and waste. And they bring the nutrients to the soil again. Plant sapling. A young plant with a thin stem is known as a sapling. Survival of living things is impossible without plants.
planting and taking care of plants lead to a good environment. Yes, so we have to plant more sapling to bring a good environment.
Let us see benefits of plants. Plants provide oxygen for breathing. Yes, we can get fresh air. And also they provide food, shelter to the living things. For birds and animals, it provides shelter and absorbs harmful gases and smoke from the surroundings. Yes, it absorbs all the harmful gases and give wood for us making furnitures and offers good environment to live and help in bringing good rainfall. Our government had brought some initiative to protect our environment. They are the CHIPKO movement in 1970, the Environment Protection Act in 1986, National Green Tribunal in 2010, and APICO movement in 1983. Did you hear the word Van Mahotsav? Van Mahotsav means Festival of Forest. It is an annual tree planting movement. This movement began in India in July 1950. This festival is organized during the first week of July every year. Plants are very important. To create awareness among the people, we can give saplings during celebrations, festivals, family functions and national festivals. We can also plant saplings on our birthday. I hope you all will plant saplings on your birthday. And if you want to present something to your family members, friends, means you can present some saplings and ask them to plant them. Save trees and save our environment.